Before the term super team came into existence, most basketball teams used to have a pair of dominant players in order to win games. And today, we look back at some of the best duos, tandems to ever play in the PBA. So, let's ask our legends here in the studio, Coach Allen and Coach Jerry, pag sinabi natin all-time dynamic duo in the PBA, who comes to mind kaagad? Coach Jerry, I'll start with you.
This was based on yung nakalabang ko. And si Danny Ayen, Danny Siegel. During that time na nag-grand slam sila and talagang high scoring sila na ano, stable sila, consistent players. They were young before. Ang daming na-produce na mga good players around them.
Yung dalawa na yan, the two Dannys, what made it so hard to stop the two of them when they were together on the court?
Grabe. I start with with Danny Siegel. Talagang he's a third all-time leading scorer sa Wagner. Talagang ang hirap bantayan with Olsen, tapos with Danny Ay, who is nagmamature. Parang yung they have that in-out formula eh. Pagka post, dinoball, kick out kay Danny Siegel, he can shoot, he can attack, he has an open game. Kompleto, a little of everything. So yun ang
What's interesting when we look at the credentials of these two players, Danny Ay is a two-time MVP, back-to-back yun. Danny Siegel, people say that he's one of the best players to never win an MVP trophy. Would you agree with that kind of assessment?
Yes. Medyo hindi nga siya nanalo, pero he's deserving din siya. Alam mo naman, pagka labanan na ng MVP, lahat meron chance eh to win the plum. So, yun lang. Hindi lang talaga. Pero marami siyang trophies doon sa finals MVP.
Yeah. Ikaw, Coach Allen, what do you think of this itong dynamic duo of the two Dannys?
Well, nakalabang ko din yan and I used to coach Ginebra sa finals noong 2001. Talagang it's very hard to stop those two. Double threat talaga sila, both sa post and perimeter. Especially noon, may illegal defense pa. So it's very hard. You need to double talaga both of them para ma-neutralize o ma-stop mo sila.
Were you like thankful na nung kalakasan mo wala pa tong dalawa na to?
Yeah, medyo sobrang na rin talaga tong mga batang ito when they came into the PBA, talagang yung impact napakalakas din.
Okay, now speaking of impact, your choice for dynamic duo, Coach Allen, ito ta time machine talaga tayo. Yeah. We're gonna go classic na talaga, OG style na to. Your choice for your all-time PBA duo.
Well, as a fan, at first, I grew up idolizing the dynamic duo, the original dynamic duo, Jaworski Arnaiz.
Yan yung original Batman and
Robin. Yes. No. But through the years, nakapaglaro ako ng basketball, and throughout the years, I considered Ko and Cesar one of the best tandems sa PBA. Kasi it's very hard to choose kung sino yung pinakamagaling talaga eh. But I consider these two, the Scholar and the Fortune Cookie, as one of the top best duo.
Yeah, so our viewers are looking at the graphic, no? So nakikita nila, may tig-isang MVP. Yeah. So these are both MVP players. And if you look at their combined number na nag-mythical team, ito yung mythical five, okay? 9 times si Atoy Ko, 7 times si Philip Cesar. I mean, how hard is it to do that in the PBA?
Napakahirap, pero makikita mo naman sa kanila parang easy lang. Both of them are members of the Grand Slam team ng Chris Pa ng 76 at 83. Balansi kasi itong dalawa eh. Very unstoppable si Atoy sa offense. Si Philip Cesar naman will complement sa defense. Kaya nga na siyang Tapal King. Tapos he's one of the big guys that can really run the floor and finish the fast break. Talagang double blade yun. Talagang offense-defense. Atoy Ko naman, talagang during his prime, wala pa akong nakikitang player ngayon na gumagawa ng turnaround, fade-away jump shot. Napakahirap nun. Paano mo mababantayan yun at may stop? So talagang, for me, sabi ko nga, these two are talagang, kaya naman kitang-kita mo, they really helped Chris Pa win so many championships.
Yeah, actually, siguro kaya wala sa Wikipedia, hindi na mabilang eh.
Hindi na mabilang.
Sa dami ng...
Two Grand Slams lang, that's
so six right agad, away yun. Eh, marami pa, aside, yes. Outside of the...
Plus, naging teammates pa sila sa greatest, right. And nakasama ko sila sa greatest, kaya I'm very fortunate na nagkaroon ako ng chance na makasama sila.
Okay, let's go a little modern here, no? Para naman yung millennials may representation, okay. Ha? You guys also feel na kailangan may consideration din yung Mark Kagiwa and JJ Helterbrand. Mm-hmm. Now, you coach these two. Why should they be considered in that list of all-time dynamic duos?
Eh, medyo biased ako dyan dahil akong kumuha dyan sa dalawa, number one. Number two, yung energy nila kasi dalawa will electrify the crowd, number one. It gives energy or morale to the team, lalo na if you're down o talagang makikita mo yung work ethics ng dalawa, and you can see naman, both of them got MVPs also and so many championships din. Iba yung impact ng dalawa rin eh, yung kaya nga the Fast and the Furious eh, during their prime, talagang ang daming sumuporta sa kanila.
Jerry, your thoughts on the itong The Fast and the Furious.
Yeah, I agree with Coach Alan. Siyempre, sino pang makakapagsabi ng ano ko. Siyempre, hanawakan ni Coach Alan. Grabing intensity. Talagang yung laro nilang pareho, it complements the team. Talagang eksakto dun sa style of play. And of course, yung crowd factor. Kasi kung slow break silang dalawa, antokin yung mga tao. So, pasok lang yung estilo nila rin sa ano.
Ako nagtataka lang ha, because at least in my view and the way I grew up, I would consider Alvin and Jerry as one of the all-time duo. Napakabait kasi nitong si Jerry, hindi niya sinama yung sarili niya doon sa listahan eh, but napapangiti ka kasi alam mong totoo. I mean, Alvin and Jerry, that's a legendary duo, di ba?
Yeah, I agree. Nasa list ko rin talaga yon, and also Benji and Ronnie. Talagang marami, kaya ang hirap talagang pumili kung sino yung best talaga. But they should be there on top.
Pero alam mo anong totoong malapit, Jerry? Yung Alan kay Dick, hindi kailangan ng katandem. Kaya mag 79 points mag-isa.
Yun
ang mahirap.
Ito, katandem ko sa UE.
Hindi, matagal na yun eh. Pero sa PBA, sobrang lapit ni Coach Alan. Kaya ko na mag-isa. I can do it, 79 points. We'd like to thank our legends today, really helping us out with our discussion. The Trigger Man, Coach Alan K. Dick, and the Defense Minister, Jerry Codiniera. Mga idols, maraming salamat.
Thank you, Ren, for the opportunity.
Still ahead, the Lady Spikers are still undefeated while the Lady Warriors earn a breakthrough win. We'll talk about that when we return.